Dry Tortugas National Park. Centuries pass. America is born and grows, with an increasing need to defend more and more of its expanding shores. This accounts for the fortification of a once lonely little islet in the Caribbean near the Florida coast. Today, it is Dry Tortugas National Park. Near the Florida coast, some 70 miles west of Key West, rests 100 square miles of ocean, speckled with seven small islands. Just getting to Dry Tortugas is a sea spray adventure. Over waters hiding sunken Spanish galleons and pirate treasure, fathoms deep. The salty air is seasoned for excitement. It's a two-hour boat trip from Key West. Boat or seaplane are the only ways of getting there. On a site called Garden Key looms this massive pile of masonry, Fort Jefferson. It took 16 million bricks to build these ramparts to their 50-foot height. Some of the bricks were shipped from Maine, over 1,200 miles away. Building began in 1846. This is the largest 19th century masonry American fort still standing. It was designed as a massive three-tiered gun platform with 420 heavy guns, impregnable to assault and equipped to destroy any enemy ships foolish enough to come within range of its firepower. In addition, a moat was dug 2 feet deep and 14 feet wide. The Isle's lighthouse guided ships through the waters. It was built in 1876, replacing an earlier lighthouse which had been damaged during a hurricane. Throughout the Civil War, the fort was manned by the Union military. This became America's Devil Island, for it was here, 120 miles off the Florida coast, that the Union Army sent its deserters. Its most famous inmate was not a deserter, but a physician who had been convicted of conspiracy in the assassination of President Abraham Lincoln. He was Dr. Samuel Mudd, who had mended the broken leg of fleeing assassin John Wilkes Booth. Dr. Mudd's cell was referred to by the soldiers as the dungeon. He was transferred here after an attempt to escape. At the fort, during a dreadful outbreak of yellow fever, Dr. Mudd gave selflessly of his medical skills in easing the sufferings of his fellow prisoners. In time, Dr. Mudd was pardoned by President Andrew Johnson. For the visitor, there is more to do than tour the fort, however enlightening that may be. The park is famous for bird watching. The isle's very isolation makes it a refuge for thousands upon thousands of coastal birds. Bird watching peaks each spring, when myriad migratory birds will pass through the park in a single day. There's also picnicking in the warming sun, scuba diving and snorkeling, exploring America's most pristine coral reefs in the velvety waters of the Caribbean. One of the most remote of all of America's national parks, Dry Tortugas is strangely beautiful in its isolation.